curious, Congressman Joey, the NUP has endorsed Martin Romualdez as who they prefer to be the next speaker. I mean, there were talks in the past that, of course, former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo would be in the running for speakership as well. But what do you make of that, given that Mr. Romualdez is a relative of Mr. Marcos? Would that look good? Will that have any effect, let's say, on foreign investors?
Una-una, talagang dumaan naman sa proseso si Martin. I was the chief campaign manager of Martin during that three-cornered fight in 2019. So kita ko naman na nung naging majority leader siya, gamay na gamay niya, alam niya yung proseso. So he gets things done, even the most difficult reforms like the Public Service Act, for example. So there ang daming laurels in his, to his credit. So yung mga, if he wants it, he will get it. So the other probably choice is former president si PGMA. I mean, dalawa lang naman talaga ang pinag-uusapan ng speaker. So pag tinin naman yung lineup, ulitin ko, PDP Laban 65, NP 36, NPC 34, NUP 33, Lakas NUCD 24. So that's already, all these are probably would be in a super majority again. So ang lumalabas na lang yan, yung mga party list, marami ding party list talaga na na loyal po kay Martin. It's not because of Marcos. I think he will get the speakership not because he's the first cousin, but because marunong talaga yan si Martin. At I think his legislative prowess, or his, I would say, the way he is able to master the legislative grind or the mill. So I think it is discussion. In other words, it will be an asset to a Marcos administration. I mean, a Romualdez speakership is an asset. So in combine mo yan dun sa Senate na parang ano talaga given na si Ma'am Cynthia Villar will be the Senate president. She will have a very strong legislative support for Marcos.
No, that's quite interesting that you're saying that, because so you're saying that a Romualdez speakership would be an asset to the Marcos presidency because he's not to his credit. So my first question there is, so you believe that former President Arroyo shouldn't even gun for it anymore?
Ah, hindi. I mean, dalawa lang yung pangalan pinag-uusapan. Total, chief of staff naman ni PGMA when nung speaker siya is si Martin, di ba?
Okay.
So
right.
Martin has deep understanding of how Congress operates, especially the House of Representatives. If the Senate has 24 presidential, then you probably have the 304 kings in the House. So dealing with all these kings, I think he has been able to do that and get things done. Okay. So I think the most productive Congress since the first Congress of 1987 to 1992 is this Congress.
All right. Okay, just very quickly, Joey, with the Senate presidency, you said you believe that Cynthia Villar is already a given, because that's not what some sources say. I mean, you do have Senator Mig Zubiri in the running. There's some who have also shown interest for the Senate presidency. Why would you say that it would be Cynthia Villar at this point?
Well, marami rin ako nakakausap, di ba, ng mga senator. At pangalawa, yung NP is the second largest party in the House. So, kumbaga, there will be a give and take. So, most likely, yung mga lakas senators, if they want Romualdez to be speaker. So, I mean, just to, kumbaga, as a bargaining, she has the bargaining chip, basically, being the second largest party, I think, in the country. And number one pa rin is PDP Laban. Surprisingly, we have 65 and I'm PDP Laban.
All right. Now, Joey, I do have another interview, but I wanted to ask you, the first 100 days are crucial. There's been investor anxiety. You have investors, businessmen already asking, what's the first 100 days? Come on. What do you believe should Mr. Marcos prioritize for the first 100 days that would set the tone for his administration?
Una-una talaga. Sa tingin ko, to address basically inflation, kailangan make the proper pronouncements, let's say, on agriculture in terms of budgetary support. Okay. Ang pangalawa is to look at jobs. I think kailangan niya ng suporta sa MSME, sa small businesses. Anyway, yan yung pinaka yan yung dalawang pangalawa yung dalawa na una niya talaga mini-mention lagi kasi nawaswas yung MSME ng COVID eh. Yun talaga ang pinaka weakest link, although that's very resilient. There's creative destruction there. So kailangan lang konting pitik o konting konting stimulus sa MSME, I think will do the job to create more jobs kasi 99% naman ng ating ano eh, ng enterprises sa MSME and 68% ng total jobs natin are by MSME. So yung pangatlo, I think basically I think he was doing, yun ang sinasabi mo nga kanina, yung makompleto kagad niya yung team. Yeah. At saka basically although there is no pressure on Mr. Marcos to be populist. So and yung personality naman niya is very conservative. Mm-hmm. Eh totoo naman yan eh, nakaharap ko na pa siya no birthday ni GMA eh. Ang bait, sobrang bait talaga. So wala kang masabi pagkaharap mo na siya eh. So kumbaga yung naiisip mo tungkol sa tatay niya at tungkol sa kanya, pagkaharap mo na siya mawawala eh kasi kasi talagang ano eh yung kanyang tonality, yung kanyang tono, yung kanyang approach sa iyo, yung kanyang worldview, eh mukhang ano naman siya eh, akma sa panahon na to na kailangan talaga natin na we need to put our hands on the paddle to get the canoe out of the storm. So talagang we don't have a perfect storm kasi domestically our structure is strong, just as Chua said, but the headwinds are definitely there. And if there's one weakness in the Philippines, the fact that we have 15 million metric tons of food imports. So yun ang pinaka-weakness natin.
Yeah. And you believe in the first 100 days, the 50 million metric tons of food imports is the first thing he should prioritize. Would it be fair to say, Joey, it's important that it dramatically is cut?
Ay, hindi yan kaya kasi structural problem ngayon. Kasi halos pati chicken, pati rice, pati beef, pati fish, puro na yan. Structural deficit na tayo dyan. So ang importante dyan para sa kanya ay para combination ng good governance niya, ay patigilin yung smuggling ng food. Dahil sobra-sobra talaga. In fact,
so may implementation factor. Kumbaga, that's one thing you're saying. As the president, the one thing he could do is make people follow the rule of law, really implement the law. Like yung sinabi mo, stop smuggling. It sounds basic, but it hasn't been successful even under Duterte's time.
That's why he can make a difference. I believe he can make a difference. He knows. I think so. Ang kanyang appointment sa finance is important. Pero ang mga customs commissioner at saka BIR, eh, lagi naman direct appointment by the president. So ang pumipili talaga niyan, eh, ang presidente. So kung sino pipiliin niya, ako, I will retain the current customs commissioner. Ang importante lang talaga diyan, eh, ma-implement talaga yung mahabulin talaga yung mga agri-smugglers. Sobra-sobra. Pinakamaraming smuggling talaga yung pagkain.
Yeah. But very quickly, Joey, I caught you there. You would recommend to retain the present customs commissioner. So if Mr. Marcos's team is watching, why would you retain him? What's the reason?
Magaling talaga siya. Unang-una, yung kanyang modernization, yung kanyang computerization tsaka IT ay talaga is way ahead of BIR. Pangalawa, nakita ko naman sa kanya, talaga meron siyang ang tawag dyan, no-take policy. Sorry, zero. I mean, at least level.
Yeah, okay. Go on.
So at this level, talaga, kasi alos linggo-linggo kaharap ko yan pagdating sa hearing. So iniisa-isa namin yung mga ginagawa niya. Pero anyway, what is clear, what is better for me, kasi in this country now, because of the, well, sabihin natin the cloud of doubt due to the latter part of the Marcos era, eh, tanin ko mapapawi yan. Because to President Marcos, I think personal is the chief policy. So if there's one chief policy, it's personal. When you say So, ibig sabihin, tao. Yung pagpili niya ng tao ay napakahalaga.
Oo. Okay, so you did say the finance is the primus inter pares of the president, and I agree with you. Who do you believe? I mean, you've seen the list. Who would be best? I mean, of course, Mr. Marcos would have the last choice, but you know, you're an economist, Joey. Who would, me coming from Sunny Dominguez and the other finance secretaries you've worked with, who in the list?
Kung ako tatanayin mo kung hindi papagod, si Sunny Dominguez.
But that's, I don't know. I mean, sources tell me the retention would be to retain Secretary Dominguez. I mean, there are talks of that, but it doesn't seem like it.
Oh, well, you asked me what is best. Yeah. The best is to retain Sunny, Sunny Dominguez.
Why would it be best to retain Secretary Dominguez?
Kasi alam niya yung mga natirang reforma na nakabitin sa Senate, na inaprubahan ng House. So alam niya kung paano yun ipuporsige. So pangalawa, I think he has an effect, impact on the other secretaries like DTI, NEDA.
Okay, all right. So
ibig sabihin, siya ang pumili ng mga yan eh. So ibig sabihin, para magkaroon ng policy continuity, as well as, of course, makomplete po yung reforms na hindi natapos, lalong-lalo na kasi na-stack up sila sa Senate eh. So,
okay. But, Joey, I'm curious.
Saka kilala, okay. Saka kilala siya sa buong mundo. The okay. Both by the financial markets, capital markets, the debt markets. At saka siyempre, ng mga analyst. So I think it's a known quantity. So if you talk about continuity of policy at the same time, of course, yung continuity of the reforms. So, ibig sabihin, it's the continuity of the disruption because very disruptive talaga yung mga reforma actually pag tiningnan mo eh. Sa
Joey, very quickly, if it's not Secretary Dominguez, if Mr. Marcos wants a fresh face, somebody new, based on the list you've seen, who do you believe will make a good fit from where the Philippines is coming from?
Alam mo, ang point ko dyan eh, kung if Marcos will give the same leeway, kasi si Presidente Duterte pinabayaan talaga yung economic policy to Dominguez. So para sa akin, hindi critical kung sino yung tao. I-critical sa akin kung anong policy space ibibigay, kung anong klaseng tiwala ibibigay ni President Marcos sa kanyang DOF Secretary. Kasi dito talaga, halos hands-off si President Duterte. So hanggang sa execution and implementation and of course the other aspects of governance ang tinuunan niya ng pansin kaya nagkaroon ng malaking success sa structural reform sa atin. So I think it's what's more important is anong klaseng tiwala ibibigay ni President Marcos sa kanyang DOF Secretary. Kung bawa sa pagpili pala ng customs, makikialam siya. Pagpili ng BIR, makikialaman din niya. Edi ano na kagad yun, makikita kagad ng market share. So, sa pananaw ko, that is far more important than the persona itself.
Very interesting. Thank you very much, Representative Joey Salceda.
Yeah, thank you also.
Always an interesting discussion with you.
Actually, you always get me the day after presidential election.
All right.
2010, 2016, now 2022. So, graduate na ako sa'yo eh.
All right. Well, thank you very much, Joey. You take care today.
Salamat din.